While we've got it on the bench and in this stand, let's make it a little bit easier and faster to upload the HMI code to the NS panel. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pop this out the panel. So we'll just release a couple of clips and we'll pull that off. And with the panel upright, so the buttons are at the bottom, we can see on here there's a couple of other pads. We've got a TF-RX and a TF-TX. And these are the TX and RX for the panel itself. So it's basically the UART coming out of here goes through those to the panel. So I'm going to connect a TX and RX to here for the FTDI adapter. And then this whole patch here is 0 volts. And obviously we need a 0 volt reference. So I'm going to scrape a bit of this off and attach a 0 volt line there. So just using the screwdriver, I'm just going to make myself a little area there so I can put a bead of solder on. And for this, I've made another lead with just 3 connections. So I've got a blue, a green, and a black. So first of all, let's tin our pads up. So the black wire first. Tap that on there. Next, green wire goes to TX. And obviously the blue wire to RX there. So there you go. Let's put this back in the case. I'll just drop all these wires through there. Line up the bomb. Clip it on at the top. So now we've got a nice little interface straight to the UART of the TFT panel, bypassing Wi-Fi so we can upload directly via serial. And to facilitate that, I've got a little box here, which has got the pins which line up with the pins there. And then my FTDI adapter will plug into this end. I'm using the switch here to isolate it, so I don't have to keep unplugging this. So if I want to upload, I just switch this to on. And then when I want to use the panel, because once this is connected, some of the touch functions won't work because obviously I'm connected to the UART, which connects the TFT to the ESP32 chip. So all this does is just isolates the RX. And I found that just isolating the RX is enough. And then I can run code from the NEXTION Editor directly into the NEXTION panel without needing to use Wi-Fi. So it makes it a lot quicker and a lot easier, and I'll show you that in a second. Okay, so this is all connected. So what I've done, I've connected my power supply back up. That'll power the whole thing in a second. I've got my isolator box connected to the leads that we just added. And then my FTDI adapter connects into the other side of the box. And we can see we've got black to black for 0 volt reference. I've got a TX and RX swapped over. So blue to green, green to blue. And let's power it up. Okay, so you might have heard the beep there, but that's powered up. We're going to move this to one side and let's look at the NEXTION Editor. And we've got it all connected over here and the NEXTION Editor is open with our Lounge Master HMI connected. What I'm going to do is on the main page, I'm just going to add a simple button. We'll put the component on there. Compile it, make sure there's no errors. Instead of saving it and then doing the TFT upload and then doing all this and it'll output to that, I'll go back to Home Assistant and press the upload button. All I need to do now to add this button to that panel is push the upload button. Now, if you know the COM port, you can set it here, but it will do a search anyway. So I just hit go and it's already found it. And you can see that now it's uploaded. And because I'm only making a small change, it's not going to take that long to upload. And there you can see we have a button available. If I want to make any changes, say if, for instance, I want to move a button, I can just go upload here, hit go. It will remember the last COM port. It'll upload it, reset the panel, and there you go. Take that off of there, and we'll put it here instead. We'll do that, hit upload, go. And you can see now it's gone from the main page. Now do remember, some of the data that's coming from this panel to the ESP chip needs to go through RX, so our isolator button there, we'll just turn that off. So now if we go to our second panel, we can see our button is there, and it's working. This is very handy for making quick changes. So I can just move it about and then just make sure that the RX for the UART is on. And then we just simply hit upload, go. It uploads the changes, restarts the display, and we're done. So again, switch off so we can use the touchscreen as normal. One thing to note, if you do make changes this way, the TFT file won't get uploaded. So you will need to go to the TFT upload, output that again once you've finished, and that'll make sure the TFT file that's saved in Home Assistant that ESP Home uses to update through Wi-Fi, which is the long way around, is up to date with the latest changes you've made here and subsequently on the panel. Always keep that file up to date just in case you upload through ESP Home. Well, I hope this video was helpful for your projects. Please do share it so others can find it as well. I upload videos whenever I can, so subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified. That's it. Thanks for watching.